What's going on, YouTube? It is Mike from the Hardcover Comic. Before we dive into Harbinger Renegade, the custom omnibus I've got in front of me, if you're new to the channel, please be sure to subscribe. If you're a comic fan, we are a channel for you. Be sure to hit that like button. It helps us out a lot. And if you are going to subscribe, be sure to hit that notification bell so you know whenever we post a new video. Harbinger Renegade was an 8-issue series with a 0-issue as well, 9 issues total. This custom dust jacket was designed by me. Had a lot of fun making it. Got to use a whole bunch of different design ideas that I've had for the book. I've got some Peter Stanchik on the spine there, and on the back, just some great artwork from the series. This artwork was sort of shown in the sort of the intro piece of the book, just sort of talking about what's happened up until this point in Harbinger throughout the Valiant universe. So just taking off the dust jacket here, guys, I apologize. All right, so on the inner flaps and on the front and back flaps, I just put these character bubbles that were in the book, just to sort of run down everyone, you know, that appears and plays a role within the series. Of course, like I mentioned, this was a 9-issue total series. It's one of my smallest binds. Got this nice blue buckram at Lehman Bookbinding in Kitchener, Ontario. That's where I do all of my binding. I used single issues for this because I was collecting the series. I was collecting pretty much everything Valiant put out in single issue format. So here are those pages I was talking about that give a sort of a breakdown on what happened in Harbinger. And this pretty much picks off where Harbinger by Joshua Dysart finished. A huge epic run that I highly recommend you guys check out. There are a lot of things happening here. We've got this Alexander Solomon character who is, we're seeing in these prologue bits. We're getting introduced to this character Jay, who is sort of interested in psyops a little bit, and he's been doing a little Googling and stuff. He's approached by basically this sort of FBI agency, FBI-like agency. And then there's also this side group of characters being run by a psyop named Enfuego, who is basically activating these psyops using his own custom machine. If you don't know, Haruto was able to activate psyops, as was Peter Stanchik, a huge character in Harbinger Renegade. And in Harbinger, the regular series, he was able to activate psyops through their brain. In this series, we do get to see Peter Stanchik return. Of course, he's been sort of in his own self-prescribed rehab out in space, dealing with everything that's happened in Harbinger, trying to get off of the chemical addiction that's driving his life. We do get to see characters like Chris return. We get to see Torque. We get to see Faith in here as well. You know, obviously characters have gone through some changes. Chris is in a relationship. Torque is sort of a movie star, you know, going to conventions, signing books, stuff like that. But Alexander Solomon is sort of the big bad of this series. And we find out where he comes from, what his connection is to Toyo Harada, and how he was involved with the Harada Foundation and psyops and all that. And we start hearing these whispers about this thing called Stormbringer. See these flashbacks where Alexander Solomon's going to the Bleeding Monk and asking him sort of about this Stormbringer. This series does also include an issue, I believe it's called Massacre, where essentially the hardcore Generation Zero and the Harbingers get together, and it's a pretty brutal issue. I won't give it anything away from it. There's a lot of characters that die in that issue. It's brutal. But we do get an issue here, sort of randomly thrown in there, where we do find out about this Stormbringer, what his deal is. It travels a little bit further back in time in the Valiant universe. Amazing artwork by Juan Jose Rip, one of the greatest artists working right now, in my opinion. And, you know, it overall, you know, within the 9 issues, you do get one complete story. You do get to find out what happens with Generation Zero after their mini-series in Rook. If you're interested in that, I did do a video on Generation Zero as well. It's sort of a companion piece to this Harbinger Renegade book. But overall, I thought this was good. Of course, after Joshua Dysart's epic run, you know, it's it was good. It could have been better. But if you're a Harbinger diehard fan, this is a no-brainer for you to read to find out what's going on with these characters and how the Valiant universe is evolving around them and how they're evolving within the Valiant universe. Thank you guys very much for tuning in. This is Mike from the Hardcover Comic. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them below. Like I mentioned at the start of the video, subscribe for more for daily videos to keep up with our content. Be sure to like the video. It helps us a lot. And if you are going to subscribe, hit that notification bell. Thank you guys very much. And as always, until next time, you stay classy, Internet.